Good morning, friends. Welcome to the discussion session of percentages. In this session, we will discuss number of questions which are based on percentages. Before watching this session, I expect from your side to watch my earlier session on percentages, in which I explained the concept of the percentage as well as the different problems related to percentage. So this session is purely dedicated to solving your different questions, right? So we are going to solve the questions one by one. I hope you enjoy the session. Let us start with the first statement. It is given that a man spends 75% of his income. His income is increased by 20% and his expenditure is increased by 10%. You have to find out the percentage increase in savings. Okay? So when we talk about this particular statement, so what I can say, it is based on the concept of income and expenditure, income, expenditures and savings, because everything is given in the terms of percentages. So I can assume my income to be 100, expenditure to be 75 and savings to be 25. In the next year, income increases by 20%, it becomes 120. Expenditure increases by 10%, it means I have to increase 10%, 7.5, it becomes 82.5. Now what is my savings? So my saving would be 120 minus 82.5, that is 37.5, right? Earlier my savings are 25.9, now it is 37.5. I have to find the percentage increase, 12.5 upon 25 into 100, divide by 4, right? And here you can say it is equal to 50%. My answer is said to be D. We can say the savings are increased by 50%. Your answer is D. Now read the next question carefully, that is statement number 2. It is given to you that A salary is 30% more than B, then B salary is how much percentage less than A salary? We have a direct formula here, 30 upon 130 into 100, right? R upon 100 plus R into 100. So here you can say your answer is said to be 300 upon 13, or I can say my answer is said to be 23.76%. One approach is this one. If you don't remember the formula, you can say A and B, A salary is 30% more than B. It means B salary is 100, then A salary is 130. My question is B salary is how much percentage less than A? How much it is less? 30. To whom we are making comparison with A into 100? Just solve it, you get your answer. Your answer would be same, 23.76%. That becomes your answer. Read the next question. It is given that if the numerator of a fraction is increased by 20% and denominator is diminished by 10%, the value of the fraction is 16 upon 21, right? First we start with the aspect. Let us assume that the fraction is x upon y. Numerator increased by 20%, it means 120 upon 100, 1.2. And the denominator diminished by 10%, 90 upon 100, that is 0.9. And the new fraction is 16 upon 21, right? I will solve it. So I can say x upon y into 12 upon 9 equal to 16 upon 21. Just solve it. 3, 4, 3, 3. 3 will go on 7. 4 will go on 4. So we can say x upon y is said to be 4 upon 7. So your answer to this question is B. That is 4 upon 7. So we can say the original fraction is 4 upon 7. Next, you have statement number 4. It is given that 1 liter of water is evaporated from 6 liter of solution containing 5% salt. My total solution was 6 liter. It contains 5% salt. It means I will take 5% of this, that is 0.3, and the rest is 5.7, that is water. 1 liter is what? 1 liter of water is evaporated. Now water left is 4.7, salt is 0.3. I have to answer percentage of salt in the remaining solution. Salt is 0.3. Right, and now the total solution is 5 into 100, that is equal to 6%. So I can say now the percentage of salt in the remaining solution is 6%. That becomes your answer. Read the next question. It is given that if the price of a rice has increased by 60%, in order to restore the original price, the new price must be reduced by. You can make direct formula. If A is increased by R%, by how much it should be decreased further to make equal to the original value, r upon 100 plus r into 100, 60 upon 160 into 100, 3, 8, 4, 2, 425. So we can make it as 75 upon 2. Answer is 37.5%. That's our formula approach. Also, you can think for this question in this way as the price of rice has increased by 60%. Earlier price was 100, now it is 160. Okay. Now, by what percentage it should be decreased? It means it should be decreased by 60, and I have to make it decrease in 160. 60 upon 160 into 100. I can make it as 23, 28, 42, 425. Take the same value 75 by 2. Your answer is said to be 37.5%. So answer to this question is B, that is 37.5%. Read the next question carefully. It's a very important question for CAT students especially. This question is asked two or three times in the CAT exam. It is given that fresh grapes contains 90% water by weight, while dried grapes contain 20% water by weight. So we have fresh grapes, dried grapes. Water percentage, content of the grape, as well as it is given that it contains 90% water percentage and the dried grape contains 20% water percentage, right? Now it is given that the weight of the dry grape available from 20 kg of fresh grapes. We have 20 kg of fresh grapes. It means it contains 18 kilogram water and 2 kilogram of content of grape. Now I have to convert into the dried grapes. We know that in dried grapes, content of grape is 80%. Because the water is 20%, that means our content of the grape is 80%. So I can say this 2 is equal to 80% of the total dried grapes. Right? This 2 is equal to 80% of total dried grapes. So here I can say we have to find the total quantity of dried grapes, that is 100%. So I may say that 80% of x is equal to 2. Just find the value of x. So what you can say? 24 by 5, 2, 2. So here I can say x equal to 5 upon 2, that is 2.5. So I can say total dried grapes that I can take out of that is 2.5. Pay attention here, what I have done here. We have dried grapes, that is 20 kg. We know that it contains 80% content of grape. That means in the dried grape 80%, it's a fresh grape 20 kg. It contains 90% water and 10% content of grape, that is equal to 2. Now in dried grapes, the content of grape will remain the same. And in dried grapes, content of grape contains 80%. It means 2 is equal to 80% of the total dried grapes. So we can simply make it as x into 80 upon 100 equal to 2. Just solve it. You find the value of x to be 2.5. That becomes your answer. Read the next question carefully. What is given to you? It is given that in measuring the side of a square, the error percentage is 5%. Is excess is made. We have to find error percentage in calculating the area. That simply means, it simply states that if side of a square increases by 5%, because when error made is 5%, it means we have taken 5% excess. So what I can say that if side of a square increases by 5%, we have to find out what is the percentage change in area. You remember earlier I told you, we know that area of the square is A into A. This increases by 5%, this also increases by 5%, right? So for finding the total percentage change, I can apply A plus B plus AB by 100, 5 plus 5 plus 5 into 5 upon 100. So that would be taken as 10 plus 0.25. My answer is said to be 10.25%. That is the percentage error in area. That becomes my answer. Check out the question again. It is given that by mistake, the side is taken to be 5% more. It means that simply means we have to answer it as if side increases by 5%. So what is the percentage change in the area? That is 10.25%. That becomes your answer. Next, we have statement number 8. It is given that if length of a rectangle increases by 20% and breadth of the rectangle increases by 30%, we have to find the percentage change in perimeter, right? When you look at this question, we know that the formula for perimeter is twice of L plus B. Okay. Here, neither we can say our answer is 20% nor 30%, nor we can say 25%. Answer to this question is cannot be determined. Why cannot be determined? We may solve the question in particular way. Suppose earlier the length is L and breadth is B. After making change, the new length become 1.2L and breadth become 1.3B. Right? For making the percentage change, first of all, we have to find the increase in perimeter. This equal to 0.2L plus 0.3B. We have to find the percentage change. Percentage change is always equal to increase 0.2L plus 0.3B upon original twice of L plus B into 100. Right? Here we cannot solve this question. Why? Because nothing is given in the association between L and B. If it is given that length is twice of breadth, we can answer it. If any association is given between length and breadth, we can answer it. But if nothing is given, it means we don't have any association between length and breadth, and they cannot be cancelled out. So the answer will be cannot be determined. The answer to the question number 8 is D, that is cannot be determined. Next, you have statement number 9. It is given that in an examination, A got 10% marks less than B, who got 25% marks more than C, who got 20% marks less than D. If A got 360 marks out of 500, we have to find the percentage marks obtained by D was. Okay. When I look at this question, we have to compare with D. Suppose D got 100 marks. It means C got 20% less than D. He got 80. And B, who got 25% more than C, B got 100. And A gets 10% less than B. Mean A gets 90. Right? Now, as per to the information, it is given that A got 360 marks. It means 94 times I have to find D. It means D got 40%. D gets 400 marks, and we have to find the percentage of D. He gets out of 500. It means 400 upon 500 into 100. That is 80%. So we can say the marks obtained by D is equal to 80%. That becomes your answer. You can answer this question by assuming that to be X. In that case, also you will get the same point. The answer to D is 80%. That becomes your answer. Next, you have statement number 10. It is given that population of a district is 296,000, out of which 160,000 were males. Total population is 296,000. Out of this, 160,000 are male. Right? Now, how many females are there? 130,000. Okay, and in that 50% of population is literate. So we know that out of this, half of the population is illiterate. That is 148,000 of the population is literate. Right? If 70% of the male are literate, it means 70% of this. So we can find 70% of this 0, 7, 6, 42, 2, carry 4, 42 or 4, 46, 6, carry 4, 7, 4, 11. Right? So I may say 116,200 are literate. That means 30% are illiterate. So I will take 30% of this. That would be taken as 00. 188 carry 1, 81, 99 carry 8, 3 or 1, 4. Right? So I can say that 49,800 are literate. Okay? 30% are literate means 1, sorry, it means 116,200 are literate. We have to find the females who are literate, just subtract it. 00, 28, 10, 0, carry 1, that is 7 minus 6. We can say that value is 8 and that is 3. So answer is 31,800. So I can say number of women who are literate is 31,800. Answer is C. Then you have statement number 11. Read this question carefully. In an examination where only 46% of the total candidate were successful, 1200 were boys. If 50% of boys and 40% of girls were successful, then the total number of girls candidate were. It is given that total 46% of total were successful, 1200 were boys. 50% of boys and 40% of girls were successful. It means we can say boys are 1200 and girls are equal to X, right? As per the question, it is given that 50% of boys are successful. It means boys successful are 600 and 40% of girls successful, that is 0.4x. And in total, 46%, of the candidate gets successful. Total candidates are 1200 plus x, and we take 46% of it. This is equal to 0.4x plus 600, right? It is a total successful candidate, and it is a successful candidate according to the total population. I have to find the value of x. So how I can take it? Just multiply this by 100. You can take it as 1200 into 46 plus 46x. And when I multiply this by 100, you make it as 40x plus 60,000. This value come here, that becomes 6x equal to, here it is 60,000 minus. Multiply this by, we can say 0, 0, 12, 6, 72, carry 7, 48 and 755, right? If I subtract, I get 4800. So 6x equal to 4800, or we can say x equal to 800. So here I can say number of girls candidate in the exam is 800. That becomes your answer. Here it is expected from your side that be very careful in calculations. If you are good in calculations, you can solve it very easily. Now, when I look about this question may also be solved with the help of allegation mixture also. How? It is given that we have boys and girls. Percentage of boys to be passed is 50% and girls is 40%. Overall percentage is 46%. When I apply allegation, I take to be 6%, here it to be 4%. So ratio of boys and girls is 3:2. In the question, it is given that boys are 1200. So I can say girls would be 800. That's an answer to my question, right? So here, by applying this approach, I can say my answer is said to be B. That becomes your answer. That type of question, I explained you in the concept of allegation mixtures. You may watch my video on allegation mixture as well as the discussion video of exercise. Then you have statement number 12. Read the question. It is given that a businessman employed a salesman at a rate of 1500 per month. He also fixed a commission of 7.5% on sales. If the salesman want to earn 6000 per month, means he wants to earn 6000, out of this 1500 is the salary, how much money he get from the commission is 4500. This 4500 is 7.5% of the sale. Let us assume that sale is equal to x. You have to find your value. So we may say x equal to 4500 into 100 upon 75 into 10. You have to just solve it. 25 4, 3 will go on 1500. Just multiply, you can say your total value of sale must be 60,000, so that he is in a position to earn rupees 6,000 per month. That becomes your answer. Next we have statement number 13. The read the question carefully. It is given that a goldsmith added 10% impurities to 50 gram of pure gold. It means gold and impurity. 50 gram is gold, 10% is added 5, total has become 55. Now it took 25 out of it. It means how much is left? The left is 30. And here we can say ratio of gold is impurity is 10:1. Okay. Now the 25 is taken. It means it is taken as 25 into 1 upon 11. How much is left now? That is, you have to subtract it. You may say it as 55 minus 25, that is said to be 30 upon 11, right? That quantity is left now. Now it is given that 10% of pure gold is added. It means total gold you have 40, and you have to find the percentage of 30 by 11. So here my answer is 30 upon 11 into 100, 30 upon 11 upon 40 into 100, that you have to find out, right? If you have to find this, you may say 4 will be cancelled out, 4 will go on 25, that is 75 upon 11, right? That becomes your answer. That is the answer to your question. You may say the answer is said to be 6.9. That's your answer. The next is statement number 14. It is given that Umang spends 40% of his salary on food articles and 1/3 of remaining on transport. He saves rupees 450 per month, which is half of the balance after spending on food items and transport. If in any question, if the question is of the remaining, take the total to be x. He spent 40% on food articles. How much is left? 60%, make it 60 by 100. After that, 1/3 of remaining on transport. How much is left? 2/3. And after that, half of the balance, that is 1 by 2. And this is equal to 450, right? You have to find the monthly salary. just find the value of x. We can take it, cancel out. 3 will go on, 2 will go on, 3 will go on 20, 20 will go on 5, and I can say x equal to 450 into 5. My answer is said to be 2250. That becomes your answer. So that is your answer to question number 14. These questions are very simple in answering. Take the total value to be x. How much is spent? Just subtract it. 40% is spent, the left money 60%. 1/3 is spent, left is 2/3. Accordingly, you can answer your question. The next is statement number 15. Read it carefully. A decrease of 20% in the price of wheat enables a person to buy 10.5 kg more for rupees 100. Right? You have to find what is the decreased price. Let us assume that the price is equal to x. Okay? First he gets 100 upon x. After decreasing the price by 29%, the new price is 0.79x. Now he gets 100 by 0.79x. In that case, he buys 10.5 more. It means if I subtract 10.5 from here, both will be equal, right? And from here, I have to find the value of x. So what I can say, I can just take this here and take 1 by x is common. That makes me 100 minus 100 by 0.79. It equal to minus 10.5. Okay. That LC would be 0.79. It would becomes at 79. So I make it as 1 by x into minus 21 upon 0.79 equal to minus 105 upon 10. That will be cancelled out. 21 will go on 5. 5 will go on 2. Right. Here I can say x is taken as 2 upon 0.79. Okay. That becomes my answer. From here I can get the approximate value of this. That is approximate equal to 2.5. It becomes my answer. I can say my answer is said to be rupees 2.5. Next is statement number 16. In an election between two candidates, Lalu gets 65% of total valid votes. What is the number of votes that other candidate Kalu gets if 25% of total votes were declared invalid? And total votes were 6,000. 25% were invalid, 1,500. How much valid? 4,500, right? Now Lalu gets 65%, other will get 35%. We have to find for other. So make it as 4,500 into 35 upon 100, right? Just multiply and you have to answer it. After multiplying 45 into 35, we may take it as 1575. So answer is said to be 1575. That is the number of votes got by the other candidate Kalu. That is 1575. Next you have question number 17. Read it carefully. It is given that in an examination 40% failed in English, 35% failed in mathematics, 15% failed in both subject. If 2480 candidate passed in both subject, we have to find the number of candidate appeared. Okay. It is given that 40% failed in English, 35% failed in mathematics and 15% failed in both subject. Right. From here we can say a total number of candidate passed. If 40% failed in English, we can say a number of candidate passed in English is 60%. Number of candidate passed in mathematics is 65%. Right? And 15% failed in both subject. Right? Here I can say at least one candidate to be passed is equal to, that is said to be 85%. At least one to be passed is 85. It means if I take this to be X, that it would be 65 minus x. So I may say that is said to be 60 plus 65 minus x equal to 85. Right? Here I can say 125 minus x equal to 85, x equal to 40. It means 40% of the total have been passed in both the subject. Right? So it is given that 2480 candidate passed in both subject. It means 40% of total candidate assume it to be x. Is equal to 2480. You have to find 100%. It would be 2480 into 100 upon 40. Just solve it. 462. So here you can say your answer is said to be 6200. 6200 candidates are there that totally appeared in the exam. We may have a look over this question. It's an important statement. It is given that 40% failed in English. It means how much passed? 60%. 35% failed in mathematics. How much passed? 65%. Right? Now after this it is given that 15% failed in both subject, right? That means I can say 15% failed in both, it means 85% passed in at least a subject. Now I can take this value to be x, and I know that the total is 85%. So I may take to be x, total is 60, that is 65 minus x. The sum is equal to 60 plus 65 minus x equal to 85. From here I can say x equal to 40%, right? Now x is 40%, now what I can say? 40% of total candidate is equal to 2480. My total candidate would be 6200. That becomes my answer. Next you have statement number 18. Read the question carefully. What does it say? It states you that the monthly income of ABC are in the ratio of 3:4:5. We have 3 persons ABC. The ratio of the monthly income is 3:4:5. And monthly savings ratio is 1:2:3. If the savings of A is 600 per month, which is equivalent to 10% of his income, right? So first of all, I just start with the savings of A. I may take that to be 3x and that to be y. The savings of A is 600. It means that y is equal to 600. I may say that value to be 600, which is 10% of his income. It means if that is 600, the income is equal to 6000, right? So from here, what I can say, I have to find out what does C spends per month. So I can say that this 3 is same as to 6000. I have to find it for C. 3 is 6000, 1 is 2000. Then 5 will be equal to 10,000. So I can say income for C is 10,000. And the secondly, I can say saving for A is 600, means 1 is 600. It means 3 is 1800, right? So we can say that the saving for C is 1800. I have to find the expenditure. Just take a difference. 10,000 minus 1800, our answer is said to be 8200. That becomes your answer. Don't make the question calculative or complicated. What you have to just take it as 3:4:5. This is 1:2:3. And he states you that A saving is 600. It means that is 600, that is 1200, that is 1800. This 600 is 10% of the total income. It means total income of A is 6000. So I may say 3 is same as to 6000. So 1 is equal to 2000 and 5 becomes equal to 10,000. Now we have the income for C as well as saving for C. We have to find the expenditure that would be taken as 10,000 minus 1800. Answer is 8200. Your answer is A. Next you have question 19. Read the question carefully. It is given that in an examination, a candidate obtained 25% of the marks and he failed by 25% of the marks. Failed by 45 marks, right? While another candidate obtains 46% of the marks and he passed by 6% marks more than that required. He gets what are the passing marks of the examination, right? So here I can say that if that value is 6% more, it means passing percentage is 40%. It means passing percentage is 40%. Here I can say earlier he got 25% and the passing percent is 40%. It means 15% is same as to 45, right? And passing percentage 40%, the 1% is equal to 3 and 40% will be equal to 120. So here I can say the candidate is required to get 120 marks in order to pass the exam. Pay attention here once more. If he gets 25% marks, he is failed by 45 marks. But if he gets 46% marks, he finds that he have got 6% marks more than that required. It means from here I can infer passing percentage is 40%, right? In the answer I have to find the passing marks. So what I can say, if 25% is same as to 45, the difference is 15%, which is same as to 45. So I may say 1% is equal to 3 and 40% is equal to 120. That becomes my answer. So that is the passing marks of the candidate. Next you have statement number 20. Pay attention to this question. It is given that 80 liter contains milk and water in ratio 4:1. Total is 80. Milk and water ratio is 4:1. So I may say that is 16 and this is 64. How much water should be added? 64 upon 16 plus x. The ratio becomes 2:3. Right? Just cross multiply and solve it. That becomes 192 equal to 32x plus 2x. 32 plus 2x. That comes here, that is equal to 160 equal to 2x, and after solving I can say x equal to 80. So here I can say that 80 liter is the quantity of the water that must be added so that the ratio becomes 2:3. I hope you are in a position to understand the concept of percentages. Some questions I have explained in this exercise. For having a grip over this topic, you are requested to first watch my first session of percentage and then watch this session. That session contains the basic questions on percentage. In further, I will also provide you a session for CAT students in which we solve very complicated questions as well as the previous CAT questions that have been asked in the CAT exam on the topic of percentage. Hope you enjoyed this lecture. Share this lecture with your friends so that they can also be benefited with my lectures. Thank you very much.